Hey guys, in this video I'm checking out the Pelican IM2620 hard case. Pelican are well known for their hard cases, and you can use them to carry anything that needs to be transported safely. You can carry a laptop, collectibles or equipment. I bought this to fit my Canon C200 camera. I use it for work, where I can carry the camera and a few accessories. Also, I wanted a case that has wheels, so that I don't put that weight on my back every time. I was searching for the ideal case size, as to not be too big and too heavy. But at the same time, I wanted to be able to put the C200 in it without disassembling it, and also fit a few batteries and lenses. I was also considering the Pelican Air, which is a bit larger than this one. The plastic of this case is also thinner, so that it can cut weight, hence the name Air. So the case material is a bit more flexible and not as hard. Supposedly it keeps its ruggedness, but it's also a bit bulkier, and I think it might have been a bit overkill for me at the moment. It's also a great option though if you want to carry more stuff. So for just carrying the camera without disassembling it, with also a lens attached and a few accessories, the 2620 seemed like the perfect hard case for me. Unfortunately, the original top handle of the C200 is a bit too tall, and while the case does close with a bit of a push, I don't think the camera will be well protected if the handle is pressed hard against the top part of the case. So I opted to buy a top plate and a shorter handle from Small Rig. After setting them up with the camera, everything seems to fit perfectly. The IM2620 is under the Storm model series, which is a bit different than the Pelican Protector series. It has only a side handle and doesn't have a top handle, instead of the Protector alternative that has both. The latches that open the case have buttons instead of the latches on the Protector models, where you have to apply pressure to open and close. So these latches on the 2620 require less force. Also, the pull handle on the Protector series is one solid piece, but on the 2620, it's a frame with a gap in the middle. These are the basic function and design differences. The biggest difference for me that pushed me towards this model is the weight. When compared with the Pelican 1560 Protector case, which has pretty similar dimensions as the 2620, the 1560 is actually heavier than the 2620. This has to be due to the lack of the top handle, and also because the trolley handle is not a large solid piece of plastic like the Protector series, but more like a thinner frame. Here, I have the version with the plug foam, which you can customize to your own liking. There are different options as well, with dividers, the Pelican Trek Pack divider system, and a few more add-ons like a lid organizer. As you can see, the case has four layers of foam, as well as a bottom layer and a top layer inside the lid. It has a couple of holes for locks, it's weather sealed with this rubber strip around the case, and has a pressure valve to equalize pressure due to being airtight and waterproof. So right now I'm gonna customize the foam to fit the Canon C200. Firstly, I'm gonna place the camera on the foam to see more or less where it should all be. Next, I saw this trick on another YouTube video. I'm gonna be using toothpicks to mark the position of each item, and go on with plucking the foam. I begin with plugging the foam for the camera. The case has multiple layers of foam, and I begin from the bottom layer going up, which I plug identically until the camera reaches the desired depth. On the top layers, I plug some more of the foam to better fit the microphone and the viewfinder. If you'd like, you can also glue the foam layers to form a solid piece. I've also seen in other videos where they also use this material called Plasti-Dip, where you spray it on the foam in order to close the gaps and the open cells of the foam surface, thus giving it much more stability and supposedly a longer lifespan. I've already applied this material on a different hard case foam, so here it is. As you can see, it looks more solid than just the foam. I glued the layers with a spray adhesive, and when it dried, I sprayed around 3-4 coats of the Plasti-Dip, which basically formed a flexible rubbery layer on top of the foam. And now it seems to be more durable when placing items in and out of it. In the future, I'd also like to try Pelikan's TrekPak divider system to see if it maybe suits my needs. It looks like you could fit more things in the case, but the dividers look a bit thin and seems like they would provide less protection than the foam. Also, I think the TrekPak system is a bit overpriced for what it is, which is a bit of plastic and foam, and that's why I opted not to get it at this time. As I mentioned, the reason I bought this case is to be able to carry the C200 along with a couple of accessories and lenses. To me, this is not a case for every job. For example, there are situations where I only need the camera with a lens, and maybe one battery, for fast and run and gun shoots. And this case is a bit bulky, heavy and slow moving for those types of jobs. So in those situations, I got the Tenba Cinelux 16 bag. It's a shoulder or hand carrying case, and it essentially opens like a doctor's bag. It has this aluminium strip which better protects your gear inside of the bag. When you open it, you can see that it fits the Canon C200 with a regular sized lens perfectly. You also have a little more space to maybe place a small lens or a couple of batteries. Additionally, it has this soft pad, which you can wrap around a lens or anything else for safe carrying. It has a front and two side pockets. I'm actually very impressed with this brand, and I think this is one of my favorite camera bags. Overall, the Pelikan brand makes some of the best and toughest cases in the world. So honestly, I think whatever you buy from them is gonna be a quality product. There are of course alternative brands like SKB, Nanook, and HPRC at various price points. For me though, this was the best case I could find with the dimensions I wanted. If you wanna check out this case, I'll have links in the description. So that's it for this video, guys. If you like this video, please click a like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for notifications. Thanks, and see you in the next one!